Welcome back to The Breakdown. I am De La Creme De La, your privileged host, and this is The Breakdown Show. Oh my God, what an evening it has been. Well, evening for me, night for y'all. You guys know that we are going to take a very close look at tonight's Village of Dalton meeting, another highly anticipated meeting with a whole lot to talk about. I've only seen the live stream of the meeting from the Real Late Night Crew channel. I haven't seen it from any other platform, but tonight we're going to look at the meeting from the Dalton Trustees channel. And the reason why I'm using their channel is because it was their meeting. Most likely, I'm hoping, the sound is going to be a little bit easier to understand what's happening. So you can listen on your own without me having to interpret as much. But we're going to take a look at that meeting together. Let me make sure my volume is up. There we go. And again, welcome to the Breakdown Crew. Forgive me for being so laid back. It is almost midnight. Well, it's 11:02, and my baby just went to bed. It has been a full fucking day. We did our day one of SeaWorld today. And if you do amusement parks or anything like that with your kids, you know, you ain't gonna get through nothing in one day. I don't even plan for it. My whole goal day one is to get a michelada, which I didn't get today. A turkey leg, which I did get today, and some custard, which I didn't get today. So that means I gotta go back tomorrow, right? To get my michelada and my custard. So we will be going back tomorrow. I'm just gearing up for it. I left my cane at SeaWorld too. I always carry a cane with me just in case, because I hurt my back about 6 months ago. Well, a little bit more than that. I exacerbated some pain that I had in my back about 6 months ago. So now I go everywhere with the cane because you never know. And I think I left it. I was feeding some birds and they got a little excited and I got scared and ran. It was a bird I ain't never seen before. I should have took a picture of it, but the bird came up like, I want some turkey leg too. And I was like, what are you? And I got up and ran and I think I left my cane. But anyway, I'll be back at SeaWorld again tomorrow. Anyway, so let me just go over a couple quick house rules before we go into this breakdown show. Rule number one, say it with me. This is not a no judgment zone. And speaking of not a no judgment zone, I do want to thank those of you who are watching this early on Patreon. Our Patreon community is growing. It is so exciting. I love bringing you guys the content early. So that you're able to watch it and digest it, you know, and be able to really dig into what's going on before everybody else. It feels cool, right? And then we got our 24/7 chat room where we can just chop it up about whatever's going on without having to talk on a video, which is really cool too. So if you guys haven't yet, feel free to check out Patreon. If you have the Patreon app, just look for Breakdown by De La Creme De La. And if you just want to use a link, then you can go to patreon.com/breakdown555. And one more quick commercial. I will be adding my hamper link to the description of this video so that you are able to get that discount code for hamper too, because I really love it. They do my laundry. They've been doing my laundry for years, literally. About 3 years now. So that's one less thing I have to worry about in my life. I just budget for the laundry to be done and then they take care of the rest. So anyway, I'll be sharing that link with you guys just in case you didn't see that discount link for Hamper, as well as the Patreon link. And I'm gonna give you one more discount code too, because all of this really does help make my life easier. I'm gonna share with you the link to get a discount on StreamYard as well, so that if you want to do your own channel where you don't cuss, use the word nigga, or talk about you know, people gaslighting scripture, as Shay at Real Late Night Crew calls it. If you want to start a channel where you do what you want to do, then I actually include a link here in the description as well so that you can get a discount on StreamYard. Anyway, house rule number two. Well, I guess that was house rule number one still. This is not a no judgment zone. Broke boys don't deserve no pussy. I know that's right. That's rule number three. Number four, I guess. But anyway, ooh, somebody got mad. Somebody felt that. Ooh, that triggered somebody. You need to get your money up. So anyway, rule number one is this is not a no judgment zone, honey. If you put your face in this place, then you are on the chopping block too. I don't go looking for much. It's not very often that I go looking for dirt on people. Me and somebody were talking about Beyonce and Jay-Z's marriage and whether or not I would cover it on this show. And I was like, well, I haven't heard Beyonce or Jay-Z say anything. So why would I talk about their business if they're not talking about their business? Why would I bring them to my audience if my audience ain't looking for them? Okay, y'all ain't here to talk about Beyonce and Jay-Z's marriage. Number two, you ain't heard now one of them say anything about anything. There are whole platforms that have spun this Beyonce and Jay-Z narrative. You ain't heard them say a word. Mm-hmm. And the last time I talked to Beyonce about something somebody said about her, she said, go find the original source. And I did, and found out that wasn't what was said. So I'm not going to talk about no shit like that. But if you put yourself on a platform, baby, you up for it. If you are a Lewis Lacey or a Kim Alston who doesn't seem to realize she took a job working for a corrupt mayor who the whole world will be looking at. So now she's overprocessed her hair trying to get a slick ponytail. And now she just look like what that nigga said I look like. What, Official King Payne said I look like a naked mole rat. I was tickled. Listen, I thought about that shit earlier this week. That nigga said I look like a naked mole rat. That shit was hilarious. But that's what Kim is looking like right now, trying to overprocess her hair just in case the news media is at a meeting. But this is not a no judgment zone. You're not going to come in here and tell nobody. Don't be judging nobody. Take it easy. Stall them out. None of that bullshit. The truth of the matter is if a person puts themselves on a platform, this is the place where we talk about it. Now, if you don't put yourself out there, we ain't got nothing to talk about. I don't go digging. This is not that show. Okay? I only dig for the truth. House rule number two. I said I was only going to spend 5 minutes on the intro, but it's already been 9, so my bad. I guess I'm on my Tiffany Henger shit tonight. House rule number two. This is not for children. My baby sleep. You know what I'm saying? She sleep. She right behind me. We in a hotel room on vacation, so she right behind me, but she is asleep. I talk like adults. You never know what this conversation is going to turn into. So, and I have very loose rules for my moderators. So, you know, you definitely can talk like an adult here. And if you're on Patreon, you know, we can get down for real, for real. But this isn't for children. Most kids will be bored by this content anyway and only interested when they hear the words dick, pussy, fuck, damn, hell, or shit. And those are the words you don't want them to hear anyway. So, you know, just to let you know, if you got sensitive ears, if you got some Pentecostal player ears, then you probably don't want to listen to this show. Ooh, this clock says 12:22. I love it. It is wrong as long, but I still love it. Ooh, I love it. Anyway, it's a whole hour and 12 minutes fast. But anyway, house rule number three. Y'all know, and I'm going to keep this rule here until we don't have to say it no more because this is a sensitive topic. Hold on, let me think. Let me see what the test is. Okay, hold on, Beyonce. Hold on, baby. Ooh, I got a good unboxing coming for y'all real soon, too. Speaking of Beyonce, ooh, I got some good shit. A good unboxing. I'm looking forward to coming to you soon. So anyway, ooh, and my phone is 55% charged. So here you go, the test. Wait, I just forgot. Oh, if you can finish this bar, then we'll talk about what you can do after that. She's your... You still singing, huh? His Highness Desire. You still singing. If you know what we're talking about, then you know you say what needs to be said about Tiffany Hilliard. Now, if you don't know, keep your mouth shut. Be careful. Remember, this is our barbecue, and you have not yet been invited. So if you want to get into the barbecue, you got to show respect at the gates, okay? So for the black conservatives and the white people who don't like black people, who look for topics like this, so you can put your racist comments in the chat, this ain't the place. Okay. I hold black people to a very high standard. But there's still some things we just don't say to our own people. And there's some things we'll never allow somebody else to say to us. Okay? You can get your ass whooped too. So anyway, rule number three is, if you can't finish, she's yours. There you go. Say. Free from infection. That's right. Waiting only for your direction. What's the last part? To be. I knew you knew it. Listen. Anyway, welcome to the Breakdown Show. Whether you are in the bushes, whether you are in the live chat, whether you're watching on Patreon, no matter where you are, what you're doing, or who you are, thank you so much for being here. I love that we have a breakdown crew of so many different kinds of people from all over the world, different backgrounds, different political beliefs, different spiritual understandings, just different. That's what makes the Breakdown Crew so beautiful. Just different. That's what a team is made up of. Everybody got their own thing that they do, and we all bring it together and synergistically bring these scam artists, dirty preachers, and nasty politicians to light. That's what we do here. Welcome to the Breakdown. That is the end of our house rules. As a matter of fact, I've already given you the occasion, and I have betrayed myself because I am 8 minutes against my schedule. So here what we're going to do. We're going to take a look at the Dalton Trustees meeting from today. The Dalton Trustees video of the Village of Dalton meeting. Now, they did two meetings, so we're going to watch both of them. Both meetings, I think I did the math already. Both meetings were finished, in about 90 minutes. Both meetings. I think the second meeting ended at 7:58. I believe it was about 7:58. We'll see. But it was really quick. The first meeting was like 27 minutes. Oh, it was beautiful. So we are going to take a look, but there is a lot in that time. Now, before we go into the meeting, and I didn't write this down, so I didn't plan this time, so forgive me for taking this extra time from you, but I'm going to take it, and I'm going to make sure you enjoy it. You will notice there are no plants here. There's no overwhelming security presence here. Mic's still popping because technology be technologying. You know, I love technology. If you don't know that song, it don't mean you don't black. It ain't black. It just means you're not a nerd like me. But not as much as you see. But I still love technology. Always and forever. I will give $5 to whoever could tell me what that song is from, where that song came from. Nobody ever knows. Anytime I try to tell somebody about that song, then they be like, what, are you kidding me? That song was there the whole time. And I'm like, yeah. You just got to stay and wait and listen. I'm interested to see if anybody can tell me where that song came from. And if you want to know, tell me in the chat and I'll tell you. Anyway, that's my own personal ode to technology when shit be fucking up. I love tech. Well, it's not my ode. Somebody else wrote it. But it goes like this. I'm going to sing it the way it was wrote. I love technology. but not as much as you, you see. But I still love technology, always and forever. That's my shit. Whenever shit be fucking up, I sing that song and everything turn out right. So I understand if the mics were popping at Dalton, but we know what's happening in at the Village. You know, Tiffany Henry just spent millions of dollars renovating the Village. So the PA system should be on par. But you notice the chairs weren't 50 miles apart and the media didn't have to go all the way to the back. And it was a whole lot of differences in that. I mean, people weren't standing outside in the rain, banging on the windows, you know, talking like Tupac. You didn't hear that. You didn't see. You didn't have. There was no need for any of it. And there were no plants. There wasn't a Michael Smith or whatever that weird looking lady who looked like she just smoked and had a hard time reading words and was using the wrong emphasis on her words because she didn't understand what she was reading. Every time she speaks, I say she must be Tiffany's aunt. They have the same nose, but it's likely, you know, I can honestly tell you she's been out there. That woman, the woman who had the army green jacket on last week, who was looking everybody in the eye when she spoke, I feel secure and loved. You know, that Avon bullshit, not Mary Avon, Avon sales lady bullshit. She, I'm pretty sure Tiffany stops by her house with a bag every once in a while. But you didn't see none of that there. And none of the department heads were there. And none of the Stan Brown and Andrew Holmes were not there. Isn't that interesting? Because they say they're about the Village, the department heads, Andrew Holmes, Lacey, the police, all of them. They say they're about the Village. So Tiffany Henry wasn't approving the overtime tonight. And let me tell you one more other thing I found out before I go into this meeting. Just giving y'all a chance to file in here, say your hellos to each other, get it all out the way and underway so we could get into this meeting. The other thing I found out, I was doing some research. I used the Wayback Machine, which is a really cool, nerdy tool that will allow you to look at someone's website almost any time in its inception. So since its inception. So if I had a website that I put up, let's say 10 years ago, and I've made changes to that website over time, then you can go back and look at some of those changes. Mm-hmm. That's how some people were able to find out that, what's that dude's name from the Breakfast Club, whose partner Caesar just got arrested because they were doing real estate scams together? DJ Envy. Thank you, DJ. I appreciate you. He's like, you're not going to not remember my name, even if it is on some scammy shit. You're going to say my name. Okay, DJ Envy, since you want me to say it. Rashad, whatever your name is. He kept trying to distance himself from the scam, but someone used the Wayback Machine and went back and saw that his pictures and name and videos were all over that website back in the day before the feds started investigating. So I used the Wayback Machine. And I took a look at the Village of Dalton and the Thornton Township websites just to get some cleaner information, you know, just to track some steps, you know. And what I realized was there was a time when Janice Johnson, if you don't know who Janice Johnson is, raise your hand, let me know. I'll be happy to explain it. When Janice Johnson was not the HR director of the Village. There was a time when Janice Johnson, her title was, hold on. Oh God, I should have written it down. It had something to do with financial administration. Her job at one point was more aligned with being part of the finance department instead of an HR director. Because I keep asking, why is the HR director cutting checks? They keep saying she's an HR director. But her title at one point was, had something to do with financial administration. So maybe she knows way, 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 way more than we could even imagine. Especially since she's operated in both roles. dealing with the overtime and the pay. Whew, that seems like a damn conflict of interest, but okay. Okay. So let's go into this meeting real quick before I realize something else I forgot to tell you. And I haven't watched the meeting from this platform yet. So I don't have any timestamps or anything. I'm just going into it blind. Forgive me. But we're going to start from the top.
Damn. Damn, my bad.
So that must have been trustee. I call all the former trustees. I still call them trustees because at one point Stan Brown was a former trustee too. Hopefully he will be again soon. But that looked like trustee Valerie Stubbs was talking to Mayor Lightfoot, who in my head looks like a long necked turtle. I'm gonna keep that rest of that to myself. But I'm going to skip through here just to get through that.
I had thoughts about that picture.
Do you notice that bitch ain't get up and speak to nobody, but it looked like she bowed too hard. Oh, there she goes. Oh, she got a picture. See, I got my own criticisms of Lori Lightfoot, not from a professional standpoint, from a pimp standpoint, from a personality standpoint. She let all those women come up and bow to her, and she didn't get up and get up. And talk to none of them until it was time to take a picture. But I see from the back of her leg, she might have some circulation issues. That's what it looks like. She got that thing when old ladies don't take care of themselves. They don't eat right. They don't take the apple cider vinegar or all the other things that I do. They get those circulation issues. When you see them get those weird looking legs where the legs become real thick. And the knee and the calf are the same size. I'm not a medical doctor or a professional. I'm just speculating. That might be why she didn't stand up. I'm gonna give her a little bit of an excuse. That might be why she didn't stand up. Whoopi Goldberg said, Whoopi Goldberg said, black don't crack, but it sure do spread. She sure did. Let me skip through some of this bullshit. Hold on. Not bullshit as in this is bullshit. I'm just going to skip through the shit. Oh, I love that shot with that sunlight. Look at these people bowing to this hoe. Bitch, if you don't stand up and talk to these people. Oh, black people. You got to understand what's happening when it's happening. We so used to having a savior. Having somebody, a messiah, having somebody to look up to that we don't realize when we're being disrespected. Y'all don't see every single one of them people came and bowed. Every single person who stood up, who this lady talked with, they came and bowed. And all the fucking picture her little ugly ass. You better do a good job, Lori Lightfoot. Or I'm going to put you in that same jar I'm keeping Tony Perkwinkle in right now. Bitch, please. You don't know who the fuck I am. I'm not here on accident. I brought all my gifts with me, baby. And they are not unto repentance, ho. Bitch. The same gifts the devil had when God liked him was the same gifts he got now. And I fucks with him. So you don't want to fuck with me. Or the people of Dalton right now. Because one thing you have to understand, people of Dalton, is that you have to have the same weapons or greater when it comes to an enemy. That's why they hired Lori Lightfoot. I understand it. I mean, I'm a fan of Dexter. I mention Dexter all the time. I wish there was a Dexter in Dalton. I wish I could be the Dexter in Dalton, truth be told. That would be amazing. I would take out Lacey first, bitch. But anyway, Tiffany would be my final win. It's just like, oh, I would just love it. I would savor that. But anyway, I said in somebody's chat tonight, I think I was in the Real Late Night Cruise chat, and I was like, put Lori Lightfoot and Tiffany Henier in the same room, and it's going to be the last episode of Dexter. And if anybody can remember how that ended, is all I'm going to say. But do you realize, do you notice all these black people, black women, and by the statistics in Dalton, most likely single black women, single black mothers, which I am one of each. Tick a box on that. Single black mother. I'm all of those. All of these women came up to her and she didn't stand up to speak to any of them until it was time for her to take a picture. She allowed these women to bow. Do you realize that you came to serve this community, Lori Lightfoot? Do you realize that this entire community is skeptical about your participation and they're on eggshells? The citizens of this community are scared because you're there. Not because you're there in a good way. They're scared you're going to take their money and run. But I believe, because I was raised by some really good preachers, okay? I believe that you know all the things. And you know how to uncover the things. You know how to ask the right questions. You know where to dig. You know where to go. I always believe you got to get a Dexter on the case. I'm telling you. Once you get a Dexter on the case, it's going to be bloody, baby. But he got the bags to clean it up. Okay? Listen, don't fuck with somebody with a killer instinct. Yes, somebody said in the comment the audio is great. I guess this is a time
to... ...with one another and all, and other commissioners and commissioner will talk to the...
Let me explain a couple things. They had already done most of this meeting in the last meeting. This was actually a continuation of the previous agenda. Therefore, there was no need to pray because it had already been done. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, me. But they are going to have an amazing prayer here. Valerie Stubbs is going to give an amazing prayer during the second meeting. And forgive me for talking so fast. I get excited. Let me slow down. Hold on. I'm drinking some coffee, too. That's a good excuse. They're not going to do a Pledge of Allegiance because it's already been done. They'll do another one in the second meeting. And they're not going to do Citizens Address because it's already been done. They're going to do that for the second meeting, okay? So for these first 10 or 15, 20 minutes, they're just going to jump right into where they were. Now, I did notice in this meeting they didn't go into the executive session, and that was on the last agenda. The reason I think they didn't go into the executive session was, number one, because all them lawsuits were Tiffany Henyard's fault. Her or Lacey or one of them dumbass cops who can't seem to pass an exam. And Dalton cops can't pass shit but gas. God damn. Incompetent motherfuckers. Did you see that officer struggling to read along with that lady last week? Let me go back to
and I will begin the roll call. So, Trustee Norwood. Trustee Stan Brown is absent. Trustee Tammy Brown.
Present.
Trustee House.
Present.
Trustee Belcher.
Here.
Trustee Holmes, he's absent. And Mayor Hinyard, she's also absent. And absent of the mayor, I'm going to ask the board to appoint a mayor pro tem for tonight.
I make a motion that we appoint
All right. Trustee Norwood?
Aye.
Trustee Tammy Brown?
Aye.
Trustee House?
Aye.
Trustee Belcher?
Aye.
We have a quorum.
Let me stop for a second. There are three things that are always going to be very important when it comes to this meeting. I categorize them in the way of person, place, thing, okay? Because it's just easier for me to remember it. Person, you always have to have a mayor or a mayor pro tem, which was not at the meeting when Tiffany Henyard was elected to be supervisor of Thornton Township. Place doesn't matter. Thing, quorum, which is four or more trustees, according to Dalton. Dalton's charter says you have to have four or more trustees to have a quorum. So if you have a mayor pro tem present in any location whatsoever, and there is a quorum, then it is a legal meeting. Therefore, every single time Tiffany Henner has vetoed a meeting, it has been an illegal veto, if that even exists. I don't know.
Thank you very much, Claire Key, and welcome to everybody. I'm glad to see so many smiling faces. Some not so smiling, but hopefully we'll get there before the evening's over. We're beginning with the continuation. We're beginning with the continuation of April 1st board meeting. So with that continuation, we're good? Okay, we're going to continuation of last Monday, April 1st board meeting. That meeting was concluded early because there was no access for all people that wanted to come in. So we felt that this space will accommodate all of the residents that want to come and attend. We feel it's important that people have access to have communication and talk to the board and share their thoughts. So we want to give special thanks to Dalton Park District as always. We have our president, Cleo Jones, or the commissioners, Sandra Wells, Commissioner Kyle Rochelle, Commissioner Gail Towers, and Commissioner Willis Harris. They're towards the back, so please give them a lot of love because I want to make sure we get them out of here. Continued support and really the direction that we would like to be in terms of partnership with one another and other community board members. So I want to thank them and make sure I extend our eternal gratitude for their partnership. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna start because prayer is important. So we'll first start with a pledge of allegiance, then we'll do a prayer, then we're gonna reconvene what we left off in the last meeting.
Okay, they did decide to do the Pledge of Allegiance and the prayer. So let me jump into my notes real quick. I think I was leaving the doggone amusement park when this part happened. So forgive me for misstating that. Now, I want to just give some quick mention of some things that I really like that I saw here. First of all, I had a really hard conversation earlier today with my bank. And I had to explain to my bank that a lot of business owners, we talk about our banks, and a lot of us have questioned whether or not we should be banking with this bank, okay? Because they seem to fuck with everything. Like, there's nothing ever straight. Everything's always confusing. You always got to make a phone call to understand why shit is happening. Like, it's really crazy. And I was explaining something to this customer service representative today, and I kept telling her, I'm not saying this to you. I'm saying this to whoever's listening to this call. Understand that my frustration that you hear is on purpose, because I understand there is a computer that is currently listening to this call. And if I demonstrate certain tones and tremors in my voice, then another person will listen to this call after you. And then the feedback that I'm giving will actually be reviewed. But if I sound too kind and too polite, then this call will end with you. And that's it. And I'm not going to leave that up to you to share my feedback. So here I'm about to give it to you. So I gave it to her. I gave her the frustration, gave her the anger, even salted in a couple, you know, peppery words to make sure the computer grabbed that call and said, this is an angry customer. Somebody needs to listen to this phone call. And in all of that inappropriate language, I gave some really good feedback, right? On purpose, did it like I was supposed to. But then at the end, the lady wanted to continue to talk about what I was talking about. And I was like, ma'am, let me say that right. When I got done saying what I said, she wanted to go back to the original reason for my call and answer my question. And I said to her, you need to acknowledge what I just said. And she said, well, I don't know the situation you're talking about, so I don't know what to say. And I said, I understand that you're frustrated. And I want to do everything that I can to make sure your issues are resolved on this call. So let's work through this issue we have right in front of us so that I can make sure that I do whatever I can in my control to help you. And she said, I'm not frustrated. I said, I am. I just told you, you haven't acknowledged what I said. And you said you don't know the situation, so you don't know what to say. And I'm telling you, the next time you get somebody on the phone who's dealing with you in this manner, say what I just said. Shit. God damn it. Where's the training? God fucking damn it. But anyway, Jason House did an amazing job acknowledging the elephant in the room at the top, in the beginning. Not even 5 minutes into this meeting, he said, it's nice to see your smiling faces. Some of y'all ain't smiling. I know we got this long neck turtle sitting here in the front. this gray-haired, long-necked turtle in a gray suit who won't stand up when people come and speak to her and is acting like she's doing us a favor, even though we're about to pay her beach house off in Malibu. I'll be down there, Lori, because I got to pour my mama's ashes on the beach. So just, you know, keep the porch in the back clean for me and just set a couple beers out. I'll be out there. But the village of Dalton is about to enhance Lori Lightfoot's retirement fund. Much, much well. Much nice. Much pretty. Okay? She's about to enhance her wealth, which she already had. Let's not get it twisted, honey. The reason why it didn't matter that Lori Lightfoot ate lobster was because she's been doing that anyway. I mean, if I became a mayor and I started eating lobster, y'all wouldn't look at me crazy. Y'all been looking at me eat lobster for a very, very long time. Y'all been looking at me take very good care of myself for a very, very long time. Drive luxury cars, live in nice homes, go on beautiful vacations, wear beautiful clothes, have a maiden or a thing, diamonds or a thing. So you wouldn't be surprised if I got into an elected position and then you saw those things happening because that's the way I've been living. Well, same with Lori Lightfoot. She's been having that experience. It's been part of her lifestyle before she was the mayor. So it meant nothing that was happening. But Tiffany Hingard, on the other hand, passed out chitlins. Gave away gas. Real, real nigga shit. Real ghetto shit. Now, but she want to go and eat lobster. Tiffany Hingard didn't even have a car when she became mayor. Let's be real. Okay? She didn't even have a vehicle when she became the mayor. Y'all saw her wig. So, of course, it became astounding that this woman is doing things a certain way, especially when the bills came to the village and the township. But he acknowledged that elephant in the room. He said, I know some of y'all are happy and I know some of y'all aren't. In his own way, he said, I get it. I understand. I know why. Now, I'm going to give you my insight before I get into this meeting. So I can just get it off my chest. I believe Lori Lightfoot is Burt Olson's idea. Burt Olson has convinced Jason, and Jason has convinced the board, and now the board has to convince Dalton. Why do I think Jason is up for it? Two reasons. Number one, he needs to be mayor, and he needs Lori Lightfoot's support and her connections. No doubt about it. It's a political move. Number two, as I said before, if you're going to catch a thief, you got to send a thief after that thief. Okay. Number two, B. Mayor Tiffany Hingard, Keith Freeman, Janice Johnson, Tangenic Miller, William Moore, Stacey Carell, Janice Darden, I'm sorry, Juanita Darden, Kim Alston, Pete McCain, Louis Lacey, DeMarcus, all the second chance boys in the public works department, all of the inspectors and enforcers inspection and enforcing, Scott Gilmore, what's your name? Kasim Woods. Yes, you, all of them are running off with the money right now. They got about $7 million between them. Who knows how many drugs that paid for? Okay? If you're going to allow somebody to run off with the money, let it at least be spent on an investigator. I've been saying for the minute, if Tiffany Hingard is going to steal the people's money, at least go learn how to speak and spell. Okay? Go get you one of those. Who was it that said they mama? Sheree said she wanted a speak and spell for Christmas and nobody would get her one. So when she got grown and got some money, she went and bought herself a speak and spell. Honey, you needed therapy, bitch. You got some unhealed childhood wounds dealing with poverty and limiting beliefs. But anyway, if you're going to spend money, if the trustees have control over anything right now, it's this. Okay. And Lori Lightfoot knows she may never get paid. Lori Lightfoot's not stupid. I'm sure the Dalton trustees are going to pay her a substantial retainer, probably they're probably going to pay her for about 100 hours worth of work up front. probably 100 hours worth of work up front, which would equate to roughly 2 or 3 weeks worth of work. Okay. If they're going to pay her, what is that? God, I hate when I have to do math. 4 times 10 is 40. So that would be $400,000, right? For 400 times 100 is 400,000. Yeah, okay. $400,000 isn't bad up front for an attorney who can find out where millions went or what's happening to millions. I would say, yeah, that's a reasonable investment at this point, because every single one of those Dalton trustees are financially vested in Dalton. They own homes there. They have businesses there. And it could be to their own personal detriment if Tiffany Milne run off with the money. So I could see investing $400,000 into an attorney who could maybe turn around an investigation in about 100 hours, 3 weeks, a month. You know, make it last forever. Who knows? But it'll probably only be about 100 hours worth of work. So I understand those reasons. I do believe it is the political benefit of Trustee Jason House, since he's the one fighting for it the loudest. When the questions were asked, who answered them? Him and Bert Odelson. Exactly. So, yeah, I do believe that it would be to Trustee Jason House's advantage. I believe that if the Dalton trustees hadn't already decided to do it, she wouldn't be there. They knew they were going to vote this way. But I love that he gave the people an opportunity to speak about it and was honest about the fact that that came from a constituent. He got feedback from a constituent that was like, hey, you really need to hear from the people before you move forward with this. So he did a great job acknowledging the elephant in the room. Now I want to make a mention to the news media, whoever might possibly be listening. I keep, you know, see, I study broadcast, right? I tell you guys all the time that to qualify where I got this information from. When I was studying broadcast, and we were learning, like I had a whole class on writing news for a newspaper, just news for a newspaper. Excuse me, because at the time people still bought newspapers, and we knew in the late 90s. Excuse me, we knew in the late 90s that with the digital era, eventually newspapers would go out of style in hand, but we were being also prepared for the digital era. Nothing's changed. We learned one thing I will never forget in journalism. A lot of what I share with you, I learned from those particular courses, my journalism understanding when it came to broadcast. But there was one thing that we learned. And you know, we have a lot of little sayings. One of them was, if it bleeds, it leads. Okay. Now, what that means is, if there is a headline that where there's blood or money involved, people are going to read that paper if it's on the front page. So if you put something, if you have a headline and you can make it as sensational, salacious, sexy, attractive, if it has anything to do with money or blood, if somebody got shot or killed, murdered, spontaneously died, mysteriously, or if there was a bankruptcy or a merger or somebody been stealing some money or some kind of corruption or something like that, those headlines sell papers. So I wasn't surprised when I kept hearing the media, the mainstream media, say the trustees walked out of the last meeting, because that's a bloody headline. Your trustees walked out. Oh, I know they got some footage, and I know it's going to be dramatic. Are these black people, somebody said stormed out. Like, ain't nobody walk out, ain't nobody storm out. As Trustee Jason House said, the meeting concluded early. There was a motion to postpone the meeting, not to adjourn it, to postpone it to a bigger, better, badder location. Trustee Brittany Norwood seconded that motion, and then they all took a vote. Okay? It concluded early. Could you guys please stop lying? We're still going to click on the story. But it's unattractive when you lie on people, okay? They did not walk out. They did not storm out. They did not march out. They wasn't singing, "We Shall Overcome." Wasn't nobody throwing fried chicken at the mayor. I know it's boring and nobody's really watching the news right now because it ain't a whole lot going on. But that doesn't mean you have to sensationalize a headline and characterize a group of people differently than what actually happened. Just like you don't report what's going on, what actually happened with Alexis Wilson and, you know, what you actually do know now. And you didn't report that the soundbite you kept using over and over again was from Alexis Wilson's mother. Kara Wilson, you got to make sure, you know, because this is not a no judgment zone, that you tell the whole truth. And again, the trustees never walked out. They've never walked out of a meeting. They've always legally concluded that meeting. Let's continue.
If we can remain standing briefly, I'm going to ask the former trustee, Valeria Stubbs, my prayer warrior, if you'll be okay with leading us in prayer, please.
Can everybody bow their heads? Heavenly Father, I come to you, thanking you for another day, thanking you for allowing us all to assemble here together and don't have to stand out in the cold and the rain. Thanking you for waking us up this morning. Thanking you for the four trustees and they have our best interest at heart. Father, I ask that you put your loving arms around this community. And anybody that's not doing your will, I ask that you remove them from the seat. In Jesus' mighty name, I thank you and give us traveling grace and mercy on our way home. Thank you.
Amen. I'm feeling nitty gritty. I'm feeling picky. So I'm going to go ahead and break that prayer down a little bit. I was right there with Miss Valerie Stubbs until she said something at the very end that kind of caught my attention. And I was like, man, here we go. Telling God what to do. Y'all know that spiritually, I believe that there is no such thing as a God, one of them, that has dominion, rule, or power over the whole universe. Like, it doesn't even make sense. There's too much power for one entity. Some of that power you had enough of that power to be chosen by your mama's egg when you were sperm so that you could fertilize it and make yourself. You had enough of your own power. I said that to say, Valerie Stubbs, Trustee Valerie Stubbs, that said at the end, if anybody here doesn't do your will, remove them. Well, a spiritual entity that you pray to, that you believe in, did not put anyone in their political seat. We got to get over that idea, okay? We got to break through the spiritual abuse and the miseducation that has taught us that God places leaders in seats. That was taught to us so that we would obey our slave masters, okay? Your Holy Spirit told me to give you a minute and let that digest. So I'm going to do that. Because I fucks with all the gods. They all know me. They call me to their attention. And I say, okay, what you need? What's going on today? And they say, oh, this is going on today. And I'm like, what you got for it? What you gonna do for it? Because I don't work for you. You work for me. Okay, let's be clear. You caught my attention. You caught me into your presence. So what do you need? Now that we have made ourselves a little bit comfortable with that idea, I'm going to say it again. The reason why you believe that God can remove Tiffany Hinyard from her seat or Keith Freeman or anybody else is because many years ago, when people were brought to America from Africa, and many Native Americans who were already here, when they were subjugated to Europeans who came to America to take dominion and colonize America, one of the tactics that was used to get African people and Native American people to obey the slave masters was religious abuse. They were beat, raped, killed. I'm not calling them settlers or pilgrims. When the European identity extremists came from Europe to America, the way they got in was they said they were coming in the name of God, glory, and gold, coming to share God, get some glory, and find some gold, okay? And one of the tactics or techniques of making sure that African people and Native American people were subjugated to their control was through religious abuse. And one of the things they did was they, you know, this was even before the slaves, but, you know, there was a guy, a king named James, who needed his people. I'm going even further back in history than slavery now, needed his people to be subject to him. So he had some people rewrite parts of the Bible to make it fit what he wanted to happen, because there is no separation between church and state. Religion is politics. Politics is religion. You'll learn that when you go to another country. When you live in another country where all this political Machiavellian bullshit doesn't exist and politicians just are who they are, evil or not, then you'll understand. Religion is politics and politics is religion. I've lived in a country where the only God I was allowed to worship was Xi Jinping. He was the president and still is the president of China. I had to sign a contract when I lived in China. Every time I signed a contract to work at a new job, I also signed an agreement that I wouldn't worship any God besides Xi Jinping. Sure, I signed the contract. You know, that's what they all tell you when you're a Christian. You're going to have to make that choice. Fuck that. I'm not a Christian. So I am God. So I can say what needs to be said and do what I need to do. And I gave tithes and offerings to Mao Zedong, who was a horrible leader of China. But my tithes and offerings to him in his death got me out of that country safely when it was time, twice. Any God you worship is going to work for you. Okay. So we got to get out of this idea that God can take Tiffany Henyard out of her seat. Because the only reason you believe that is because thousands of years ago, hundreds of years ago, who knows when, somebody put in the Bible that God places people in authority. And then a slave master beat it into your great-great-grandma. And she beat it into you. Yes, she did. She did beat it into you. Because if you didn't get up and go to church, what did you get? A beating? Okay, I hear you. I know it's uncomfortable, and I'm not here to change your paradigm, but I am here to make a difference. And the difference can only come from a contrast of ideas. Get into it. God did not place Tiffany Henyard in her seat, as much as God didn't place Donald Trump in his seat, as much as God didn't place Barack Obama in his seat. The people voted for Tiffany Henyard. So you can't pray that God, how's God going to remove Tiffany Henyard from her seat? Miss Valerie Stubbs, with all due respect, what do you think God is going to come down and pluck her out of her seat? Pick her up by her wig and throw her out the window? Like literally, no, this is, nobody's going to come save Dalton. Here's the lesson that Dalton is having a difficult time understanding. Ain't nobody coming to save you. And even when Lori Lightfoot does her investigation, you have to do something with the information she finds. Everybody in the world knows about this, who's politically attuned at this point. It's just crossed everybody's desk and nobody's come to save you. You didn't look for Lori Lightfoot. Lori Lightfoot didn't come looking for y'all. You guys went looking for her. And she's known about this. So I have an issue with us still thinking that God is going to remove Tiffany Henyard from her seat like some magical, supernatural fairy. But I'm a witch. and you're praying that God remove her from her seat without being willing to do the work it takes to get it done. But I'm the witch. I'm the bad one. You want some spontaneous overnight change instead of doing the political work and changing the political culture, imparting education, imparting respect, changing this culture where people think they can't criticize the Dalton trustees because they are the Dalton trustees. No, you guys have done a lot wrong. You have a lot of responsibility to take in this situation. Y'all thought you were going to be able to control her. Let's just be honest. And she told you, yeah, I know I don't know that much. Whatever y'all want, I'll do. Whatever y'all say, I will take your leadership. I know all of y'all are more experienced than me, so I'll do it. And then she turned on you. Let's be honest. All of you had your own agendas. And you were going to use her to get to it. And now you look crazy. And you praying to God to save you. No, Dalton. Just like you have to save your own money and manage your own finances, you have to save your own town and manage your own politics.
Thank you for that. So we're going to reconvene to pick up on point number 5.
Oh, you welcome, Jason. I know. You welcome. Because I know Jason been in his spirituality too, and he can't tell y'all this because Dalton is so religious. But Jason can't tell y'all. I am not going to tell his business.
The general announcements at that point was where we continued the meeting from April 1st. There are, as we may know, and if not, I'll make sure we're clear, there are two agendas. We are continuing the April 1st agenda, and that's where we're picking this up. Once we reach the conclusion of this agenda, we will adjourn this portion of the meeting and then go directly into our special board meeting, which is the second agenda. So just so everybody kind of has a heads up on the direction we're going. So for general announcements, I'll yield to any trustee if there's any general announcements.
I'm in the comments, right? Somebody said Uncle Lori is in the building. Lexi said, Lexi, I see you in every single one of these chats. I love you to death, Lexi Shay. Lexi said, now explain Beetlejuice. That's all anybody's talking about in this chat is Lightfoot. The I can't even say this. Somebody said. Okay, I'm going to tell you who it was, and I'm going to let you read it first, and then I'm going to read it out loud. I don't want to take it from you. 1, 2, 3. The third comment from the top, a guy named Wrecked Turtle. He's right above Bonita Esquire with the brown picture. Y'all read that, what that nigga said. That nigga said, what the fuck? He said, the fuck Smeagol doing there? I can't get over it. She looked like my precious. But that's all anybody talking about in the chat right now.
Good evening, everyone.
That's why I'm glad Jason hit that head on at the top. But anyway, let me let them get to their announcement.
We have a special surprise today, and we don't take stuff lightly that goes on in Dalton. So I know a lot of people see stuff that's happening on YouTube, on Facebook, and different things. The reason I'm standing up because I seen something on Facebook last week that really struck a nerve to me. We are not responsible for what our police officers do. We will hope that they will do what's in the best interest of the community. But the video that went out with Ms. Hill getting put out and that baby crying really touched me because it was like you were ruining a special moment for a little child. So today we wanted to make sure that he won't look at Easter so in a negative way. Ms. Hill, are you here? Come on.
Ms. Hill! Chicago is here in the building. I don't think they knew either.
Special little basket because we don't want that negative light on our community. Yeah. about these things impact small children, and we don't want him to think of Easter as a negative thing. So we just wanted to make sure that he had his capacity.
I'm telling you, I was in traffic today, and I was so grateful I was in traffic because I got to hear this and listen to it, and I was crying. Oh my God, I was crying because, first of all, Ms. Hill reminds me of my people. My daddy's from Chicago. He was raised in Cabrini Green on the west side, and it's just a different, you know, it's a different way that people talk when they're from that part of the world. And Miss Hill sounds so much like when I call my big brother after he got off work and he had a couple beers, and he just gets it flowing on the phone. And I write shit down when he be talking. I just be taking notes, you know, just listening. And my dad was a lot like that too. You get that man on the phone and he would just let you know. He would just let his heart speak. Listening to Miss Hill, she is so full of wisdom. Like, she been there and she's done that, and she still looks good throughout it. She is a woman of honor, I can tell that she's embraced life. You know, she's embraced life, and I really appreciate that. So that moment was beautiful to me. For Miss Trustee Kiana Belcher, just a piece of feedback. It might be time for you to hire a tailor.
Good evening, everyone. Saturday, April the 20th, is the Cook County Missing Persons Day. The Cook County Medical is Missing Persons Day.
I did hear some of these, so I'm going to go ahead and get through them because I don't think any of the rest of the general comments were.
Trustee House, when we get a chance, can we have a moment? Okay. Sorry, not today. I'm everyone's warm. We don't shoot the wood. Our email coming out. And take see me after the meeting if you want to attend. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Okay. Thank you very much, trustees. We have
Somebody in the comments said, I love when people are keen. Because people get, we get blasted and knocked down a lot for being sensitive. There's nothing wrong with being sensitive. You just have to learn how to control what you feel and know where it came from. All emotions can't be something everybody got to know you feeling. Shit. But the person at the very bottom of the comments, the very last comment said, you can actually feel the peace in the air. And that's true. That's why I knew Tiffany Henry wouldn't be here. She's an agent of chaos. This isn't her kind of place. These aren't her kind of people. This isn't her kind of situation. And it's not her moment. Tiffany Henyard is one of those people. I've noticed in my life there are people who can't, they will never support what anybody else got going on, regardless. It doesn't matter how much everybody supports them. They will never support anybody else. And I'm actually going to bring back a video, Tiff, that I have not, bring out a video that I haven't discussed with you guys about the last time Tiffany Henyard was at the Park District at a meeting. What happened? What happened? I can't wait to show you guys. She ended up running out of there. I'll just tell you that much. And then we'll get to what it is. I have to write that down. Hold on. I've been ruminating over that for the longest. I need to go ahead and do it. There we go.
Our agenda is the village clerk's report and approval of meeting minutes. I yield to the clerk, Keith.
Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. I am requesting the board's approval of the regular board meeting minutes from March the 4th, 2024.
So moved.
Second.
Okay, Trustee Norwood?
Aye.
Trustee Tammy Brown?
Aye.
Trustee House?
Aye.
Trustee Belcher?
Aye.
Motion passed. Thank you very much, Board.
Thank you. There are several reports on here that we did not have department heads or individuals present, so we will be skipping Village Administrator's Report, Engineer's Report, Department Reports, Police, Fire, Public Works, Water, Housing, Building, and Code Enforcement. And we'll go next immediately into our...
So- So by this time into the agenda last week, Tiffany had already left, remember? Because the young lady showed up, pulled her mask down, and showed her face. Most likely she's at this meeting too. But by this point, remember Lacey was giving his report. And she was going to go down the line. You know, I'm sure Pete was next, Kim was next, straight up from there. But whenever I hear now what was left on the agenda, all I could think of was, hurry up. Because that's all we heard next. We didn't hear the police or fire reports. We heard, hurry up. Coward ass.
More of this payments that we need to approve. In doing so, I'm going to make a motion that we approve the electronic AP warrant list, removing the following items: Aurelio's Pizza for $131.63, Cooper's Hawk $557.68, Dollar Tree $145.32, Food for Less $107.99, Irie Jerk Cut $1,356.22, Johnny T Bistro and Blues $90.30, Kirk's Barbecue $676, and Ruby Soul Food $674, Sophia Tamales and Corn $2,400. Southeastern State Supply, $17,500. And the Tasty Crab, $458.79. So my motion is to approve the warrant list, removing the items listed. Now that's for a second.
Second. Y'all, before they get into that second, I just want to mention one thing, because this is the first time us together as a Breakdown Crew have heard this item eliminated from the warrant list and have not. I don't know why it hasn't come up before, because the bill is over a year old. These $17,500 skates, honey, that are locked up somewhere. Tiffany here, you won't tell nobody where the skates are, but she got $17,000 worth of skates.
Okay, here a motion and second. Any discussion from the board? Clerk, please roll call.
Sure. Trustee Norwood?
Aye.
Trustee Tammy Brown?
Aye.
Trustee House?
Aye.
Trustee Belcher?
Aye.
Motion passed.
So next is the approval of our accounts payable warrant list. I motion that we approve the warrant lists, removing the following items. On page 5, Delgado Law Room, $48,001.15. Existing Concrete, $14,123.03. Five Star, $122,325 even. John's Pro Trees, $155,000 even. K&M Ventures, $183,950 even. Lopez Lawn Maintenance, $10,050. Mosca Design, $65,700. Podkarski and Sons, $32,360. Raul and Sons, $181,950. And White Coat Pool Solutions, $34,780.58. Our motion is to approve the AP warrant list, removing items listed. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay, hearing the motion and second, what was going on here? I think that we wanted to...
Hell no, we going back and we listening to that again. We got time tonight. Okay, because those costs were crazy. Fucking crazy. Especially when you find out that all those costs were to do the same thing. Cut a tree or cut a grass. Let's listen again. Let me go back.
Motion passed.
So next is the approval of our accounts payable warrant list. I motion that we approve the warrant lists, removing the following items. On page 5, Delgado Law Room, $48,001.15.
Now, I just want to say this. I'm going to write down Delgado. He's some bitch-ass nigga. So, Stan Brown, the difference between the electronic warrant list and the AP warrant list is, excuse me, I got the hiccups, is the difference between a deficit and a debt. Okay, I want to mention that, Stan Brown. And Tiffany Henyard, too, because you play dumb. You act like you don't know this either. The electronic warrant list, which was the first list Jason House called, Trustee Jason House, Mayor Pro Tem Jason House called, was the electric warrant list. Those are items that have already been paid for by electronic means, wire transfers, ACH debit cards, credit cards, okay? Those are not, those would be like manual checks, that sort of thing. Those are, that's where money has already been spent. Okay, Stan and Tiffany. And when more money has been spent than revenue brought in, then you have a deficit. Okay, so a deficit isn't based on people who aren't getting paid. That's not where that $7 million came from. It didn't come from people who aren't getting paid. It came from too much fucking payment. Too much money going out. Money actually already been paid. Now, a debt is what we're going to find on the AP warrant list, the account payable warrant list. These are companies that are have submitted an invoice or whatever, and they're not been paid yet. They're still wanting money. That's a debt. Okay, that's where a backlog of expenditures is. The backlog of expenditures is not in that $7 million and it's not in the electronic warrant list. It's in the AP warrant list, the accounts payable warrant list. That's where the backlog of expenditures are. And that's not a $7 million deficit. That is debt. Okay, there's a difference between debt and deficit. There's a difference. When we talk about a deficit, we're talking about money that's already been spent that is greater than the revenue that's been brought in. When we talk about a debt, we're talking about money that is owed, that has not been paid yet. You're welcome. It's my pleasure.
Since existing concrete, $14,123 in warrant lists. I motion that we approve the warrant lists, removing the following items. On page 5, Delgado Law Group, $48,001.15. Existing concrete, $14,123.03. Five star, $122,325.
No. I love you. I appreciate you, Jason, Trustee Jason House. But we're going to take a slow walk through these. Delgado, $48,115. Now, you heard Tiffany Hinyard say, what lawyer you know can get the bill to pay his bills, can get the board to pay his bills? And Trustee Kiana Belcher said, the one sitting next to you. Isn't Delgado a bill on the warrant list? Tiffany Hinger's trying to slip in her attorney's bills. Her personal attorney who whispers to her and her friends. You ain't never seen the. Now, I'm going to tell you about the original setup in Dalton. If you go back and look at pre-Tiffany Hinyard meetings, the administrator and the mayor didn't sit together. Sorry. Not only did the administrator and the mayor not sit together, the administrator and the lawyer didn't sit together. The mayor and the lawyer didn't sit together. These people sat in three different places in the room. So when Tiffany Hinyard asked the administrator a question, the administrator got up, walked to the mic, and answered the question. When they had to confer with the attorney spoke out loud over the mic and gave them all the same advice at one point. He ain't whispering in nobody else's ear for them to interpret what he said and not listen to it and do what the fuck they wanted to do. Tiffany Hinyard has totally bypassed all the procedure that lends to fairness and transparency. The way that entire space is set up is a psychological mindfuck. Because there is no reason for the attorney for the village to be sitting next to the mayor or the administrator for that part. The attorney for the village should be in a whole separate section, so he's obviously fair and unbiased. But this fucking attorney is very biased. His biases are all over the place. And they all lean to Tiffany Hinyard and the paycheck she's supposed to be getting him. But bitch, you didn't get paid this week, ho. You stayed all that extra time last week, Mike Delgado. Thought you was going to get shot at the end. I know your head was on a pivot. I saw that motherfucking neck on a swivel. I think Mike Delgado probably played football in high school. Because his neck... He got that football neck. Oh, it was lacrosse. I'm sorry, lacrosse. My bad. my bad. His head was on a swivel that whole fucking time. You think he was in the middle of New York City somewhere? Shit. He got them wide set eyes for a reason. but you didn't get paid your $50,000 this week, sir. Let me see if you show up to the next meeting. So here we are. You stayed all extra time and you didn't even get paid. Now let's go to existing concrete, which is $14,123.15. I thought it was so funny today when I was on the phone with the lady from the bank and she tried to say my bank balance and she read it like Stan Brown and she got it wrong because she ain't used to reading that many numbers. Anyway, I was tickled. Anyway, I honestly think, and I haven't gotten that amount for Five Star yet, I think Five Star and Existing Concrete are the same company, and I'll tell you why in just a minute. Hold on.
John's Pro Trees, 155. We're moving the following items. On page 5, Delgado Law Room, $48,001.15. Existing Concrete, $14,123.03. Five Star, $122,325 even. John's Pro Trees, 150.
Okay, so here we go. Here's why I think Existing Concrete and Five Star are the same company. Five Star has always had these six-figure invoices. And that's why the former mayor, Riley, didn't fuck with him. Okay? Five Star, the dude at Five Star, I think his name is Dwayne. He looked like an old mafia guy. Old Al Capone type nigga. He's always had six-figure bills. Okay? Now, he had a bill, this $122,325 bill is low because they just sent him $1 million. What was that? Last summer? They gave, no, this was, what are we in now? April? It must have been November, December. They gave him $1 million, $1 million check. He got $1 million check and he's still submitting invoices. Of that $1 million, $850,000 of it was for the ice skating rink. And I don't even know if the, the only reason they went ahead and paid that is because he threatened to sue. And trustee Tammy Brown, of course, was like, if he's threatening to sue us, pay him his money. So now we got companies extorting the village. But I don't understand why there's a Five Star that does concrete and another company called Existing Concrete. Why are there two concrete companies for the village? Why? And what is Existing Concrete anyway? I mean, Five Star has been doing work for the village for who knows how long. Even when Riley Rogers, if that's his name, Roger Riley, I can't remember. People call him Mayor Riley, so I can never get it. I don't know. It sounds like a camp counselor to me. I'm looking up Existing Concrete, y'all. Hold on one second. Existing Concrete. Are they in Illinois or is there another company called Existing Concrete? I don't see one. Let's see. But they just might not be paying Google to put them at the top of the search. Existing Concrete Company. Because, you know, Tiffany will oftentimes get a company from another country, another state, to do work for the village, like Protec, who came from somewhere else, who knows. Let me see if they're in Illinois. Existing Concrete. I'm not seeing. I would have to go to a Secretary of State website and look. I'm not seeing, I'm even seeing an article, 5 best concrete companies in Illinois, and it says missing Existing. So what is Existing Concrete? I mean, it's a lot of concrete companies. Let me see. And see, there's no invoice, there's no receipt, there's no anything. So they don't have anything to base it on. Five Star Concrete Services, I'm able to find. Of course. I don't know where he is in Illinois, but I know that he's in Illinois. There he is. Five Star Concrete and Construction. So what is existing concrete? I mean, that literally sounds like they just put a name, like they owe somebody some money. You know, somebody dropped $14,000 worth of drugs and they owe somebody and they got to get this bill paid because nigga been knocking on their door. Y'all remember that Umar Johnson live when his mom called because somebody was knocking on her door looking for him? And he continued with his life. I hope he paid that debt. But I think, you know, I wanted to take this slow walk through these, through this AP warrant list, and I'm glad I'm doing it. I'm not sure if Existing Concrete isn't a different company than Five Star. And it might just be an easy way to get some of these bills paid. How does Five Star have a bill that's exactly $122,325? No taxes? Nothing? How does Existing Concrete have a bill that's exactly $14,123.15? Really? Really? No taxes or nothing? Delgado, $48,115 to the T. No taxes? Y'all ain't paying taxes? Y'all aren't collecting taxes from your customers? Because if I understand correctly, a village is not exempt from taxes. It's not a nonprofit organization. It's a government. And governments are considered profitable businesses. Oh, yeah, they are. Uh-huh. They're businesses. The business is called government. It's the business of government. So, yeah, they pay taxes on their products, too. I'm wondering what the fuck is going on with these two, but let's continue.
$5,000 even. K&M Ventures, $183,950 even.
K&M Ventures. I believe he said $155,000. I'm going to listen again to see.
$1.15. Existing Concrete, $14,123.03. Five Star, $122,325 even. John's Pro Trees, $155,000 even. K&M Ventures.
Here we go with another even bill that doesn't make sense. I mean, I tell my daughter all the time, game recognized game, baby. You play games I got away with. Like, you do shit I actually got away with. $155,000 even for K&M Ventures. Now, I thought at first K&M Ventures was one of Keith Freeman's schemes, but K&M Ventures, I believe, is a tree cutting company. Yeah, I know. I would never guess to name a tree cutting company K&M Ventures either, because ventures is usually what you call a business that's going to be several different businesses. But K&M Ventures LLC does excavating, hauling, koi ponds, pasture fence, yard installation, fence drain. No, I don't know. Hold on. Let me see. Yeah, they're out of Tyrone, Pennsylvania. And I believe they're a tree cutting company. Let me double check. K&M Ventures Limited. That can't be right. This says the business dissolved. Well, that can't be right. Oh, I'm looking at the UK. Let me get back to America. K&M Ventures Incorporated. Oh, are you incorporated? Because K&M Ventures, did you know you don't have to put a comma behind that? Markham, Illinois is where they're from. And they got a bunch of thirsty bitches on their Facebook page. I am trying to see what they do. I think they cut, I see grass in their logo. but it's not telling me who they are or what they do. They have a public group on Facebook called KNM Ventures Incorporated. It's a group, not a page, with 23 members. And they share, people share stuff on their page about all kinds of shit, which doesn't make sense to me. Why would you have a group where people just talk about nothing? Oh. Let me try this a little bit differently. Hold on, I'm gonna get you some information. I'm almost certain that is the, that is a tree cutting or grass cutting company. Especially since they had grass in their logo. This is the one in Illinois. But they have themselves as an LLC. So are you incorporated or are you an LLC? Because there's a difference. K&M Holding. Okay, they're coming up on a civic search. $8,333. K&M Ventures, $46,000. Damn, they've been submitting some crazy bills to the city of Dalton. There's a lawsuit involving them, too. Percentage of recent Dalton board meetings that mention the term KNM. Wow. I didn't know people actually did this type of data analysis. Most popular meeting mentioning KNM in the past 2 years. Damn, I love the internet. I told you guys I love technology. There is a website that will search how many times a name of an entity is mentioned in a government board meeting, where it's mentioned. So they've Dalton, Illinois, Pickens County, budget discussions, waste management. That's that mafia shit. I told you. They were in court in 2010. For whatever. Custom machine and fabrication. That can't be right. So they look like a fucking shell company if you ask me. At one point they were KNM Enterprises Incorporated. KNM Investments LLC. All these are the same fucking company. KNM Ventures. Is this a real company? Okay, they do have a Dun & Bradstreet. Let me see what their Dun & Bradstreet says. My login through my account. See if I can get some backwards information. Hold on. It's processing my request. Okay. It's got me on a timer. Let's see. Looking for a credit report on K&M Ventures. Access the company's payment. Yeah, I'm going to log in through my Dun & Bradstreet. Kunche Bay is the key principal. Who is that? Lessors of real estate and rental leasing. Okay, let me tell you what this company says they do. Real estate, automotive equipment, rental and leasing, commercial and industrial machinery and equipment, rental and leasing, consumer goods, rental, general rental centers, lessors of non-financial intangible assets, except copyrighted works, offices of real estate agents and brokers. So they do everything. I would have to log in through my Dun & Bradstreet account to get this information on the company. But the reason why I'm digging like I'm digging is because I just don't believe that all these companies are doing work. I don't believe it. I believe these companies are fronts for drug companies, for drug enterprises. I do. I believe K&M Holdings, K&M Ventures, K&M Development, K&M Resources, K&M Investments LLC, K&M Enterprises Incorporated, K&M LLC, K&M Holdings Incorporated. All these are the same company. They have the same exact information, and I do believe that this company is a front. It's a whole front. I do believe this company is a front, because $155,000 lickety-split, no tax, no fees, no nothing. Just $155,000, no receipt, no invoice, no nothing. And that's the reason why it's not being paid, because there's no receipt, there's no invoice. They're not able to see what the fuck is T. There was no RFP, there was no presentation, there was no bid, there was nothing. And I can't figure out for the life of me what the fucking company does, for real, for real. I know they were talking about tree cutting. I told you most of these companies, all these companies are doing the same thing. So we got two concrete companies. And so far we got, on their Facebook page, it shows grass. So I'm going to say it's a grass cutting. Okay? And we know Stan Brown is over the Thornton Township grass program. So who knows what the fuck is going on with that? Well, his unintelligent ass. Only Stan Brown could see everybody go out the back door and then walk toward the front door. Only Stan Brown. So $155,000 with K&M Ventures, who I think they cut grass based on the logo on their Facebook group. But nothing else about this group or anything else about them tells me who they are, what they do, and what should be expected of them if they're on a contract, if they're on a warrant list. Nothing about, not, there's nothing clear. This is fucking ridiculous. Let's go. John's Pro Tree Services.
$183,950 even. Lopez Lawn Maintenance, $10,050. Mazda Design.
Lopez was $10,000. John's Pro was $183,550. Now, here's the thing. Lopez Lawn Care. Okay? That's lawn care also. So, why we got K&M Ventures and Lopez both doing lawn care, and we talking about how much was Lopez looking for?
3 cents. Five star, $122,325 even. John's Pro Trees, $155,000 even. K&M Ventures, $183,950 even.
I got those backwards. So, John's Pro was the $155. K&M was the $183. $183,000 to cut grass? $155,000 to cut trees, trim trees back? Really? See, Tiffany Henger was on Mayor Riley's head about $25,000 to John's Pro. I guess she figured out how to make the deal with them too. She was on his head about $25,000 to John's Pro and asked, are they the only tree cutting company? He said, yes. But now she turning in a warrant list where they're asking for $155,000. That's crazy, isn't it? And they're not the only tree cutting company.
Lopez Lawn Maintenance, $10,050. Mazda Design.
Lawn Maintenance, $10,050. Whose house was that for? Because that's not landscaping. That's not lawn care. It's lawn maintenance. There's a difference. There's a difference. You know the difference. If you have it, if you do it, if you outsource it. What's the name of the company? Green. Tree Green. True Green is my favorite company. They always make sure whatever's going on is fine and I always got good green grass. Listen, but I don't pay $10,500 even in a year. It ain't that much grass to maintain. It ain't, if you're maintaining lawns, this isn't, like, what are you doing for real? And that's the lowest bill.
$65,700. Pines Pro Trees, $155,000 even. K&M Ventures, $183,950 even. Lopez Lawn Maintenance, $10,050. Masta Design, $65,700.
Master Design was actually approved for payment, even though they shouldn't have been, in my opinion. Master Design was those banners with Tiffany's old pictures. And I love you, and there's nothing you could do about it. If that's not abusive, then you know she don't love you. And there is something you can do about it. You can remove her from her seat in your own way. God ain't gonna do it for you. Again, let me remind you, the only reason you were ever taught that God puts people in office is so that you would obey your slave master. I know, somebody didn't hear me say that the first time, so it was a complete shock this time, but that's why. So Master Designs was the Christmas ornaments that are still up on Sibley, because while Tiffany Hinyard stole the money to get them put up, she forgot to steal the money to get them put down. But no, that wasn't approved. I'm sorry. I just lied on myself, because it's on the list of things not to be taken, not to be paid. So the reason why it's not being paid is because it wasn't appropriate. It wasn't an appropriate purchase. A $50,000 Christmas tree, a $1,500 star on that Christmas tree, $20,000 for banners of the mayor's face and sayings. And those bills were created by Stacey Carrell. Why? He made the orders. The bills have his name on them. The same Stacey Carrell who went back and cleaned up the mayor's desk when she ran out because her kryptonite was in the room. That's the same Stacey Carrell who ordered the Christmas lights and the banners and now is dodging the vendor. Won't answer the phone, won't answer emails or nothing.
$32,360. Pines Pro Trees, $155,000 even. K&M Ventures, $183,950 even. Lopez Lawn Maintenance, $10,050. Masta Design, $65,700. Podarsky and Sons, $32,360. Raul and Sons, $181,950.
Okay, Podarsky was the one who was cutting trees before. I'm sorry. Not John's Pro. Podarsky and Sons is another tree cutting company, $32,000. So far we got John's Pro at $155, Podarsky at $32, and then Raul's, who is a grass company.
And White Coat Pool Solution. Masta Design, $65,700. Podarsky and Sons, $32,360. Raul and Sons, $181,950. And White Coat Pool Solutions, $34,700.
And White Coat is the one who wants to charge $80,000 to repair the swimming pool, which it shouldn't be nothing wrong with it, but it is. Raul's is charging $181,000. I really want, at some point, I would love if the trustees would just sit down and explain to the people who are in that room what each of those items are and what those warrant list items are for. I'm not saying that thing actually happened, but that's what the item is for. The item, Raul's, is $181,000, almost $182,000. $1,000 to cut grass. Now, people have to submit income information in order to get a part of the grass program. Not because it's free, but because you charge on a sliding scale, right, Tiffany Hinyard? And when they come in and they apply for the lawn cutting program, don't you make them bring all their income documents in hard copies? Don't you, Tiffany? So you're able to see, based on their income, how much they can actually afford to pay in taxes, right? So that's why you keep trying to raise the taxes, because you know people can afford it. Fucking bitch, you're crazy.
$180.58. Motion is to approve the AP warrant list, removing items listed. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay, hearing the motion and second, what was going on here? I think that we wanted to... Master Design... Somebody have that invoice in the library on what that one is?
I don't have it, but I'll tell you what it is. The Moscow Designs was the 122 banners for
$19,888, and also the $65,000 for the Christmas ornaments that still come on nightly. So those are those two invoices, and as of last week Friday, they still have not been paid. And we were told that the check has been sent out. I talked to the vendor Friday, no payment for the banners, nor payment for the Christmas ornaments. Thank you.
So I'd just like to reiterate, if anybody watched the March meeting, when we had discussion about these items and the $65,700 came up, if you go to 1 hour and 35 minutes, our finance director said that the items had been paid in cash. And we're still waiting on the receipts. And if they had been paid in cash, why is this vendor still contacting us asking for payment? So when people go and say things, everything is recorded. And it goes back to our transparency and lack thereof that we're not getting information that we're requesting. Because as soon as she said it, I instantly raised my eye when we start paying $65,000 in cash anyway. And then for this vendor to still contact us, emailing us saying that she hasn't been paid, really draws concern. Where's the money?
So what Tangenique Miller is going to say is that when she said cash, she meant an electronic form of payment like a wire transfer. And she's not lying because she showed the judge too.
Thank you, trustees. Here no additional comment. I'm going to ask Clerk Keefe for a roll call, please. Do you have a comment?
I had some residents contact me over the last few days. I know one of the invoices on there was for the $17,000 for skates. This is part of the reason why we have to dig so deep into this, because once before, we did vote on skates, and Trustee Belcher asked the administration where the skates were located so that everyone can have access, and she basically was told that it's none of her concern. So when we look into something like the ice skating rink, I want everyone to know that as trustees, it's not that I'm not available for ice skating rink. But when the residents say, well, how much is it? Or when is the operating hours? These are the things that are a concern for us. And this is what we mean when we talk about transparency. We need to have this information so that we can tell a resident, well, it's from this time. It's not fair that we've spent $1.3 million that wasn't approved by the board on this ice skating rink, but the ice skating rink is only accessible when the administration want to use it for their private events. It's just not fair to the residents, especially when we're using taxpayers' money. So that's my stand on that. Thank you. Thank you, Mayor. I know. I just think that.
Very much. So hearing no further discussion, I'll ask
Kirk. Wasn't that weird that so many people clapped for her? Everybody spoke and everybody clapped for Brittany Norwood. I thought that was really cool, but I mean, Trustee Kiana Belcher just spoke. Trustee Tammy Brown just spoke. Nobody clapped for them. And then, okay, I mean, that's cool. Everybody got their base.
People, roll call, please.
Again, this vote is for Corporate Bill's AP warrant list with the exceptions that Trustee House mentioned. Trustee Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Tammy Brown.
Aye.
Trustee House.
Aye.
Trustee Belcher.
Aye.
Motion passed to pay AP warrant list with the exceptions that were mentioned by Trustee House.
All right, next on the agenda, there's no old business. We'll go to new business. Item A is a motion to terminate contract for Olson Murphy, Frazier, McGrath, and as legislative counsel. Attorney Olson, you want to make this motion? Okay, so I'll ask, is there a motion to terminate the contract? Hearing no motion, that fails to proceed. Next on the agenda is a motion to override the mayor's veto message that was issued on March 4th, 2024. I will make the motion to override and elaborate if we have a second. So we'll see if we have a second.
Second.
For clarity, this motion to override all items listed in the veto. In that veto, it listed, it vetoed item one, the transferring of litigation files from Delgado Law Group to Olson Murphy, Frazier, and McGrath. Item two that was vetoed, referring the Delgado Law Group to the appropriate agency for misconduct, essentially. Item three, the motion to approve payment of specified invoices owed to Olson Murphy, Frazier, and McGrath. Item four, directing the village administrator to provide access key cards to the trustees so that we can have our meeting at Village Hall, and the clerk as well. Item five, directing the village administrator to make payments to tender all payments made to the village for any reason, including Las Vegas junkets, the mayor's Tahoe car payments, and security deal from June 1st to present.
Please forgive me. I got distracted. I was in the comments. I got to go back a few seconds and listen again. Please forgive me.
A law group to the appropriate agency for misconduct, essentially. Item three, the motion to approve payment of specified invoices owed to Olson Murphy, Frazier, and McGrath. Item four, directing the village administrator to provide access key cards to the trustees so that we can have our meeting at Village Hall. And the clerk as well. Item five, directing the village administrator to make payments to tender all payments made to the village for any reason, including Las Vegas junkets, the mayor's Tahoe car payments, and security deal from June 1st to present. And those records should have been turned over within 7 days. That has not occurred, and that was vetoed, and now we're here to override that. Item six, all monetary payments to Delgado Law Group will only continue in his capacity as village prosecutor, which is what he was originally approved for. Item seven being the discussion and approval of the intergovernmental agreement the board approved with Dalton Park District. That intergovernmental agreement was put in place so that the Park District can get the permits needed to receive a $600,000 grant to beautify the parks. That was vetoed, and we are here to override that today. Last but definitely not least, item number eight was the approval of resolution 24-002, which called for the investigation of Mayor Tiffany Hinyer. Item six. All monetary payments to Delgado Law Group will only continue in his capacity as village prosecutor, which is what he was originally approved for. Item seven being the discussion and approval of the intergovernmental agreement the board approved with Dalton Park District. That intergovernmental agreement was put in place so that the Park District can get the permits needed to receive a $600,000 grant to beautify the parks. That was vetoed, and we are here to override that today. Last but definitely not least, item number eight was the approval of resolution 24-002, which called for the investigation of Mayor Tiffany Hinyer.
So when we discussed that override, he made a lot of things that were extremely important, right? So important that it got us so excited. I almost stood up and did like this. But the most important thing for us at the moment is two things. One is the partnership with Dalton Park District, the intergovernmental agreement. One of the main reasons why we're here today is because great leadership understands that teamwork makes the dream work. So we're supposed to be coming together. My 17-year-old, he attended the Dalton Park summer camp for like 4 or 5 years straight. I mean, it's a wonderful place. It was a nice place for the summer for him to have something to do. And these are the type of things you want to support, not just as a trustee, but as a resident. I want other parents to experience what I experienced. My son got to the point where he's like, okay, Mom, I'm just getting too old. But now that he's retired, I'm looking forward to seeing new youth there. And then secondly, he mentioned the keys to Dome Village. That one's extremely important because it brought tears to my eyes to see that at the last meet, we had our seniors standing outside in the cold. I don't know, you know, I don't make much mention of it, but during a lecture while I was running, that December before election, I lost my grandmother, and then two, 3 months later, I lost my great-grandmother, and I lost them both before the election. But what was funny is that God worked in mysterious ways, right? I lost two grandmothers, but God gave me about 100 more. And when I see my grandparents standing outside, I was kind of upset, right? This is our village, and we all should have access to it, not just the trustees. I mean, we're all one beat, one sound, one community, and I think that that's the most important thing that us as trustees are just trying to get through to the community. We're all one. So if you all can't come inside the building to conduct a meet, guess what? There will be no meet because there is no meet without the residents. How do we discuss business pertaining to them without you all? That would really make no sense. So I just want you all to know that we did hear you all and we seen you all, and that was the reason why we're here today. So now that you all are safe and sound and you all made it today, I just thank you all for showing up. Thank you all for your support. And we're going to get those keys to this village, guys.
Very good. Let me speak to one thing she said. I said this to myself earlier today. I don't know. I'm highly critical of the trustees because they deserve the same criticism as anybody else in this situation. This is not a no judgment zone. I don't know what kept any of the trustees from getting up and going to the door and opening it. I don't understand what kept any of them from getting up and walking to the front door and opening it. What kept you from doing that? I don't understand. I'm having a hard time understanding that. It would have seemed the most simple thing to do. Just get up, walk to the door, and open it.
Thank you very much, Trustee Norwood. Any other discussion at this time? Okay, hearing none, I will ask Clerk Key for a roll call.
Item number 13B, override of the mayor's veto issued on March 4th, 2024. Trustee Norwood?
Aye.
Trustee Tammy Brown?
Aye.
Trustee House?
Aye.
Trustee Belcher?
Aye.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Board. We're going to come to the adjourn. One item that I did neglect the general announcement, so I want to make sure I mention it. Our former commissioner here for the Park District, Kevin Owens, will be hosts the largest giveaway in the South Summer Christmas in July, so be on the lookout for more to come on that, because that, really we have so many toys and it will be a great opportunity, so please be on the lookout as we proceed. This is going to conclude the continuation of last week's meeting. So we're going to do a motion to adjourn on that and then move into our special board meeting. So I'll make a motion that we adjourn the regular board meeting, or the continuation of the regular board meeting. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay, here a motion and second. I'll ask Clerk Key for a roll call.
Trustee Norwood?
Aye.
Trustee Tammy Brown?
Aye.
Trustee House?
Aye.
Trustee Belcher?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned at 6:57 p.m.
So as I transition, I just want to make sure.
That meeting literally took 27 minutes. That's beautiful. And that's all it should take. And they got a whole lot done without being abused or berated or threatened or lied on, cheated on, talked about, mistreated, buked, scorned, talked about, show us their bone. They didn't have to deal with none of that shit. And in 27 minutes, they got a whole lot done. Now, I'm going to let you go here for now. I'm going to come back with a part two. This is obviously going to be a meeting marathon type of thing. So part two will cover the next part of this particular meeting, which I assume is going to go into the Lori Lightfoot conversation. So for now, that's all I got. Oh, she's sleeping. Ain't got no more. That's how my baby do it. I holler.